Hi, welcome to Numerix video blog. I'm your host, Jim Jockel. Continuing on the theme that we see in the markets of vanilla instruments getting more and more complex, especially around derivatives pricing and all of the inputs now as it relates to profitability, joining us today is Alexander Antonov, who is SVP of Quantitative Research here at Numerix. Alexander, how are you?
I'm fine. Thank you, Jim. Well, I hope you too.
Thank you for joining us. The thing I want to talk to you, if you haven't seen it already in Risk Magazine, in the March edition, it is a must-read. Co-authored paper by Alexander Antonov and Barclays' Vladimir Peterberg, titled Options for Collateral Options. And Antonov, I just want to give a very quick summary from the report, and I want to get into a couple questions. So the summary is, when collateral can be posted in multiple currencies, pricing even the simplest derivative involves optionality, which is often tackled numerically. But by conditioning on a risk factor to make variables independent, this can be simplified. This paper shows that this approach is both quicker and more accurate than more obvious methods. So the first question I have for you, Alexander, is what are the obvious methods in the marketplace, and what are some of the challenges by past approaches?
Okay. There's probably a couple of words about the subject itself. Imagine you have a portfolio, a big portfolio with our counterparty, and it can contain even vanilla instruments, something quite easy. Then, if you have in our agreement, in our credit annex agreement, if we have an option of the currency to post as collateral, then we can take either of the currency to post. And this makes the option. So having said that, we should calculate this option for any time horizon in the future in order to come up with an efficient discount factor. So we know that the discount factor to discount our payments coincide more or less with the collateral rate. Here we have two rates. One is in foreign currency, another in domestic currency. So we should take somehow the maximum. So mathematically, this problem is equivalent to calculation of the expectation of the exponent of basically two discount factors. We take the bigger one or smaller, depending on the site. Imagine we have a smaller, so we should. We're looking for a bigger rate to take a smaller discount factor for our collateral posting. So mathematically, this problem is equivalent to calculation of a zero bond or a zero coupon bond, as seen of today, to have the discount factor for so-called black shadow model. This model has appeared in early 90s, it's very, very long ago, and it was related with the following quite simple process. We basically take a short trade for the Hallweg model. We know this is a normal process with the mean reversion, and we take a maximum with a zero. At all times, people were afraid of the negative rates. So to generalize one of the Hallweg-Waschek model, they just cut it below the zero. So below the zero, just zero. And so effectively, this problem reduces to solve zero bonds for such a model. We know that for Hallweg standard model, the solution is very simple. There's an analytical simple formula. However, for this black shadow model, its analytical solution is impossible. So the simplest method here is to simply, is to calculate exponent of the expectation of the integral of the rate in very simple manner. So this answer is approaching the exact one for very, very tiny volatility of our rates. So in the small volatility regime, we can have this first order approximation, which is simple and efficient. We can also take a second order approximation in the small volatilities of our rates. However, this method appears to be quite slow. So the accuracy is not that bad if we compare with simulation. However, the speed is not satisfactory. And as we said, that we should calculate the discount factor for any tiny point on our yield curve, which build up to 40 years, for example, it means that we need for speed. So our methods need to be very, very fast. So that is why we have proposed our advanced method instead of these two simple ones.
So Alexander, my question for you is perhaps you could explain a little bit of the work you and Vladimir Peterberg, who's head of quantitative research at Barclays, did to improve the simplified mathematical approach taken by many institutions today to solve this problem.
Yes. So actually, as I said in the first part of this video blog, the problem mathematically is related with the calculation of the zero bounds for the Hallweg model with a zero floor. So simple setup, but not that simple to solve it mathematically. To come over the simple methods, which are probably fast, but not that efficient, but didn't have sufficient accuracy, we came up with the conditional independence methods. We have some of them, so that is why our paper is called Options for Collateral Options. You have the option to choose which method to use here. So basically the main idea is to freeze somehow the central stochastic factor corresponding to the whole process, then make this process conditionally independent for different times. In this case, we can calculate the zero bond integral easily using kind of Black-Scholes analogous formula, and then we integrate over this freezed factor. How to use this factor to how to use this conditional factor? It is a question of probably art, and we have proposed several solutions. Some of them has better accuracy than the when the other ones, but probably the for the cost of more time spent in the calculations. So we are just a few methods like this, which of course overperform all the previous simple methods, and gives you the calculation tools how to calculate the effective discount factor when you have multiple currencies in your collateral deposit.
So in your conclusion, and you stated some elements of this, is while the traditional approach of utilizing analytic methods might be faster and efficient, there's an overemphasis in this approach as it relates to choice of numerical method, whether it's finite differences, et cetera. What is the best practice or best approach that individuals should be thinking about as it relates to validation of new processes or selection of analytic methods as it relates to implementation within a portfolio?
In our paper, we have used as validation method, we have used finite differences forward PDE, and it is described in quite a lot of details in the paper. So this is a validation method for this analytical approximation, which we always compare it with the analytics.
Well, Alex,
and probably just a couple of words to conclude the whole presentation is that of course the impact of this collateral choice, of this collateral currency choice, with respect to the trivial zero volatility choice depends of course on the volatility of the movements of two currencies can be relatively big. So people should be careful to take into account this volatility. Of course, if the final answer is tiny, if the adjustment is tiny with respect to trivial deterministic rates, we just say okay, definitely we shouldn't take all this heavy mathematics and use it. However, if the volatility effect is quite big, then of course people should take it into account when they do these calculations.
Well, Alexander, thank you so much. I want to thank you again for joining us today. And, the paper, Collateral Options, published in Risk Magazine in March, is available at numerix.com. You can request it right there. And we'll make sure that it's readily available and published on our LinkedIn site. So please feel free to follow us on LinkedIn or on Twitter at analytics.com. Alexander, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you very much, Jim. Thank you.
And I hope you'll join us again soon.
Sure. Goodbye. Okay.